So we've come to the end of our Halloween reviews. Let's finally talk about a Scooby-Doo movie. I've seen him go up against zombies. I've seen him go up against witches. Crappy CG. Now it's about time that he meets his most oppressive foe yet. That being... The WWE made some promotional tie-in with Hanna-Barbera to have their wrestlers appear in their cartoons like the Flintstones and Scooby-Doo. Yeah, the Flintstones. Given from what I've seen, they don't need to make sense, they don't need to look good, or provide any substance. They just want to get some extra ad space in the form of your favorite Saturday morning cartoons. If this seems like the brainchild of Vincent McMahon to you, look no further because he sells himself in the film like Tim Cook at a Best Buy.
Mr. McMahon!
Vinnie Mac!
The boss!
The higher power!
The Mac Attack!
The Mac Daddy!
Daddy Mac!
I can't believe I'm saying this, but I wish I couldn't see him because this is the Scooby-Doo WrestleMania mystery on the Cartoon Palooza.
The movie focuses on the only characters of Mystery Inc. who represent the WWE's stoned and schlubby fanbase as they play the world's most improbable video game. Basically playing a special level, you win a trip to WWE City to meet their favorite wrestlers and watch WrestleMania. Now, how the heck does that work? How do you win a trip through a predetermined video game? And a city? What, there's legitimately a city for wrestlers? Is this recognized by the United States for sounding completely stupid? Is this something Donald Trump would do? Have we as a society finally accepted big corporations as our new founding fathers and creating towns dedicated to their ungodly nature?
Oh jeez, the less I think about it, the better. Let's just go back to the mystery.
So after years of taking down threatening ghosts, monsters, and zombies, the gang somehow stumbles upon a mystery involving... a bear. Actually, it's supposed to be the ghost of a wrestling bear. That just happens to be a man in a suit the whole time.
What do you expect me to do? Save on spoilers? This is Scooby-Doo WrestleMania Mystery. The only reason you clicked on this video was to see me talk about that scene where John Cena punches a boulder. But I'll get to that eventually.
They split the movie between two stories, mainly because connecting the WWE to Scooby-Doo lore might sound freaking ridiculous, but I digress. Scooby and Shaggy convince Fred and Velma to help them get their WrestleTopia or whatever it's called. However, Daphne's the only one who's against going there. They never explain why, and a scene later, she's totally obsessing over the wrestlers. Does she have a long-lost relative in the WWE? Is she ashamed of her unknown roots? Or does she know becoming a raging sexaholic at the sight of John Cena? When the gang gets to Beatdown Boulevard, we find out all about this place in traditional WWE style. There's a soap opera rivalry between one of the wrestlers, Kane, trying to seek quote-unquote vengeance for keeping him from victory at one of the events. They make him out to be the monster among the wrestlers, but giving my little understanding of the WWE, I find corporate Kane to be 10 times more menacing.
I can assure you that the monster is lurking just beneath this veneer of civility, anxiously awaiting the right catalyst to unleash it.
He'll file your taxes and kick your ass at the same time.
Through a misunderstanding, Scooby is accused of stealing the wrestling belt. This leads to a match being set up between him and Demon Kane. Again, not to be confused with the actual Hellspawn. Shaggy agrees to help Scooby, and they all get training from New Jersey's finest, AJ Lee. Not that I don't think the female wrestlers of the WWE are bad, but if you can't have this god-ugly Wyatt siblings, can we get some monstrous woman to wrestle? You know, just to even out the playing field?
Screw it. Let's just get to that scene.
Yes, your eyes don't deceive you. This is probably the one reason why anybody would have expected me to watch this crap. There's legitimately a scene where out of nowhere, John Cena jumps in front of a big-ass boulder and throws it off a cliff to save the mystery gang. And yeah,
I didn't edit the music in there. That's what they use for this scene in the movie. Not only is this scene painfully plugged to promote the wrestler and make kids see him as this godlike juggernaut, but it feels oddly inappropriate. While they establish the wrestlers to seem like they're nothing but brute strength, we later see a scene where Cena gets knocked out cold and out of commission, which makes this strange-ass scene seem out of place. Look, wrestling's not a hard concept to grasp. It's not rocket science, though, it's what people like about it. Seeing jacked men and women beat the crap out of each other, mixing some cheap soap opera storylines, pitting the everyman against the corporate machine. It's a formula that, as a comic book and primetime television fan, I completely understand. Just one I never really invested the time to really care about. I think it's frustrating that the WWE sells themselves out like this. But then again, I'd be lying if I said it's a sin to humanity. Without professional wrestling, we wouldn't have professional performers like Dwayne Johnson, Macho Man Randy Savage, and that guy. So if I come down hard on this movie for being a corporate sellout, I'd be missing the point as the true reason why this movie sucks. This may have been made just to promote the WWE, so chances are there were two types of people going into this. The WWE fans or Scooby-Doo fans. I think it's got a lot for the WWE fans. But for the Scooby-Doo fans like me, who doesn't really like a lot of razzling, I didn't like it at all. While it's not uncommon to have a special guest appear on Scooby-Doo, but those were episodes. This is an hour and 30 minute movie where we have to tolerate the Mystery Gang kissing Vince McMahon's butt. If you like wrestling and Scooby-Doo, chances are you'll find some enjoyment out of it. A very, very, very small chance that this would occur, just to reiterate that. Otherwise, forget about it. This brings me for today's question. What is your favorite WWE wrestler? I know I've been kind of getting into it, and I made a joke about it earlier, but I do like Kane. For some reason, it's the mask, the whole thing with him being, you know, split personality. It's kind of entertaining, I guess. Well, this has been another good year for Halloween on the Cartoon Palooza, and thank you for watching. I'm Joey Tedesco, and I'll see you next time.
Nah, I can't finish it. Ugh. Oh, I'll finish it eventually. Happy Halloween.